Hello everyone, Assalamualaikum. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk about the design procedures in removable partial denture or the cast partial denture. So in this video, we are going to talk about the armamentarium, what all things are required for the designing purpose and how do we actually design. And taking help of an example, we are going to design a cast partial denture. So if you want the complete notes, which you can see here, you can get it on Dr. Teeth app. You can also access many more videos and notes on our app, so you can become a Prime member and start learning better. So without wasting any further time, let's jump right into the video. If you like it, please give a thumbs up. It really motivates me and a comment will be highly appreciated. So let's start. First, we are going to talk about the armamentarium. What all do we require? Obviously, a surveyor is what we require. And we need few colored pencils. These are the red, black, brown, and blue. Okay, we'll be seeing what color is needed for which purpose. We need a ruler. We also need this caliper, which you can measure, you know, precisely. And we need a PMMA powder, polymethyl methacrylate powder. Why do we need that? To make the surface glide. Which surface glide? Here, this is our surface where we have to keep the cast, right? So in order to make the cast glide effortlessly on the surface, we use this powder, okay? Then this surveyor obviously has these attachments. These are the analyzing rod. This is how it looks like. It's just a straight rod, right? Then undercut gauges. If you zoom in, you will see that it has an end like this, okay? So it basically measures the undercut, okay? And then carbon marker. In case you don't know what is an undercut, if this is a tooth, all right, the area which is below the highest point of contour. Highest point of contour means it is the broadest here. Let us suppose it is broadest here. So below it, obviously, it will be having less width. So this area will be acting as an undercut where you can engage something, especially your clasp, okay? So this was about the undercut. So we have undercut gauges, which comes in various sizes. These are 0.10 inch, 0.02 inch and 0.03 inch. There are indications of these. We'll be seeing it, don't worry. What are the indications of using each of these? Then carbon marker, okay? You must have seen those thick lead pencils. This is basically what a carbon marker is. You can mark on the cast using this. Then we have a wax knife. It obviously looks like a knife. Wax knife is used for carving the wax, which is put to block out certain areas on, you know, for the processing part of it. We'll be seeing that later, right? So these are the basic armamentariums we'll be requiring. Let's proceed. Now, this first question is, which undercut gauge is used for which material? So we know that there are various types of materials of a cast partial denture, right? So we'll see which undercut gauge is used for which material. 0.010 inch undercut gauge is used to position the retentive clasp, which is constructed from the chrome alloys and the titanium alloys, okay? 0.020 inch undercut gauge, it is used to position the clasp which is made from wrought wire. Nevertheless, majority of wrought wire clasps should be placed in 0.015 inch undercut. Then we have 0.030 inch undercut gauge. It is rarely used and it is likely to be used to indent the surface of the cast during tripodization procedure. We'll see what is tripodization. Basically, you have a cast and you have to mark three areas of the cast to orient the cast in the same position next time you place it on the dental surveyor. That is tripodization. So this particular undercut gauge, this has no other function but to indent the surface, to make indentation cross, okay, during the tripodization. Now let's talk about the color coding. We saw that various types of, you know, pencils are used while designing. The first one is the red color. So red color is for the placement of the tripod marks. We just now discussed tripodization. So those marks are, you know, done with the red color, tripodization. It also denotes the required action. You know, red has been used in even our day-to-day lives as an alert, like the red light in the traffic, right? So red denotes required action. Also, prepared. For example, if you see a tooth on the car colored like this, that means rest seats are to be prepared here. Okay, that will be solid red. And in case you find this kind of, you know, lines, it means that you need to recontour. So it is outlined in red and then filled with evenly spaced diagonal lines. Okay, so it also can be used to denote the recontouring needs. Then also relief. Relief is shown like this. Like if you have a particular area, I'll be showing you in a cast. Like if, let us suppose this was the area and I had to relieve it, I would be making a design like this to show that you need relief in this area. Now coming to black. Now black denotes the survey lines. Okay, we had learned about the various types of survey lines. So to denote that, we need the black color. Also, it is used to enter the information on the base of the cast. Also, like you can enter the type of tooth replacement, what type of clasp is needed, and the depth of the undercut. Okay, all things you can mention using the black color. Coming to the blue color. Now, this blue color you can see here, right? So it talks about the portions to be made of acrylic resin. So this will tell you that acrylic resin will extend till here. Basically, the pink part of the denture. And then coming to the brown, it denotes the metallic part. So this design in brown, it tells about the metallic framework, okay? The CPD basically.